We're talking sorghum now with our precision nutrient specialist, Dr. Brian Arnall. And Brian, you have some studies out here right now looking at nitrogen management in some of your sorghum fields.
Yeah, so we're at Perkins Research Station. We have some fun studies here looking at a lot of different management in sorghum, but two really kind of come into play for today. This is a nitrogen timing study. It's actually our third year of doing this. And the question is, how late can you wait on sorghum? So you're standing in the check, which is really yellow. It's not ever going to receive any nitrogen. You can tell that it's behind. And I'm right next to the pre-plant, which got everything up front. And so we're actually delaying it out. And so we're at boot stage, heading out in some plots, and we're still applying nitrogen. So the take home, we're looking at how long can you wait? Can you be deficient? Can we get the crop in the ground? See how it's doing before we call the fertilizer truck and rig and say, okay, it's now time to pay the money and put the inputs in. The first 2 years of data showed pretty consistently that as long as we got the nitrogen on by boot, so where that boot is starting to swell in the crop and you're seeing that up, and it was able to be reined in, we're able to recover from even the most extreme nitrogen deficiency, and not just recover, but make more than we did in that check that was applied early season. This Perkins is a sandy soil, so that check hardly ever keeps up with the in-season applications. And so we see again this year, the check is looking good, but our in-season applications are looking just as good. So those that are anywhere to 30 to 40 days after planting, where the boot's coming, you just before the boot and it get rained in, is good. So it might be too late for our early season sorghums to have that much of an impact, but I would take that into consideration with our double crops that are out there that were probably rushed to be applied and might be getting up without a whole lot of fertility on them.
You also have another study that's going on as well in this area. So talk a little bit about that.
So you know, not everybody has the capability to have a sprayer with drops. And, you know, I get a lot of questions about, I've got my sorghum, I want to fertilize, but how do I do it? And what damage do I cause if I use urea or use UAN? And so we went out this year at a lot of locations all over the state and basically applied nitrogen when the sorghum was about knee to waist high in every way we could, including probably the ways that I'd not recommend. So we dribble banded urea down the rows where it's not on plants, and we broadcast it, make sure we had urea fall in the prills. Then we used liquid, and we used a lot of methods at widths with liquid. So we had methods where we could put drops down. So we actually had a drop that went between rows and put it right on the soil. We had that same applicator streamer nozzles were over the top, and so we got burn on some leaves. And we had streamer bars, which is another configuration. And we also just had a flat fan, which just put nitrogen everywhere. So when we put nitrogen on in the summer, it's going to create a burn. So each one of those nozzle configurations create a different level of burn. And so our question was, how much burn can we have, still get benefit from the nitrogen, and still get benefit and not lose that photosynthetic material we need? While I would never recommend the flat fan, I recommend putting, if you can, put drops down, and so you can get it in between the rows and on this double crop, or just those streamers so you concentrate it more. From early work that we see, we can take a fair amount of tissue damage. The nitrogen is valuable enough to take some burn on that leaf tissue.
With this kind of tip, the summer that we've had, kind of a lot of rain, but then kind of some dry spells, what are some issues that you're maybe might be seeing in regards to leaching?
Yeah, so seeing quite a bit of leaching right here where we're at. This Perkins location is a sandy soil. And so that's, you know, I mentioned a little bit earlier that pre-plant doesn't do well here. That's because we have a deep sand. And so every year that we have very much rains in June or July, which we've had plenty at the end of June, July, we have leaching of our nitrogen. And we've also had leaching of our sulfur. We've had enough rainfall that pushes that sulfur down, maybe below the root zone, because the roots haven't really had to explore the soil that much because they've had good moisture. And so in some of these areas, I'm seeing some nitrogen deficiency and I'm seeing sulfur deficiency. Now, if we're at heading stage, we're really kind of behind the eight ball and can't do too much. The corn's at tasseling. There's been some work that shows nitrogen at tasseling has some beneficial aspects, but it's hard to get on. So maybe if you can fertigate on your nitrogen for your corn and your sorghum, that might be an opportunity.
Alrighty, thanks, Brian. Dr. Brian Arnall, precision nutrient specialist here at Oklahoma State University.